Hi everyone, trust you're all doing well. Just wanted to encourage someone with the scripture I was reading this morning. I watched this video of this lady in, I think, South Africa. She lives in one room. That one room, she lives with her three children and I think son-in-law or something. She has her bedroom, lounge, kitchen, and a space where they actually bath. And what struck me about this woman in the video was she was so happy, she was content, and you could tell it was not a facade, it was not for show, it was not for her being shot in that video. She was just content. And at the end of the video, the one thing that really, really, really got me thinking was when she said, "You know what? God is my provider. God is my supplier. God is my source." And she said, "My salary is not my source. God is my source." So I just thought to encourage somebody who is probably like me. Your source of income was coming from your business. Maybe you sell, maybe you run a certain service which currently you're not able to, and in your head you're thinking and cracking and wondering, what am I going to do? I've got an employee, I've got employees to pay, I've got salaries, I've got rentals, I've got so many things to do, so many things to pay. How, where am I going to start? I just wanted to encourage you and say, you know what? We have to make the word of God a reality for God to be our source. The whole day today, I kept thinking about this woman's statement where she said, "My salary is not my source. God is my source." Many times we have said it to ourselves that, you know what, God is my present help in time of trouble, in time of need. God is my source. God is my provider. But this morning and from last night, the reality of making this word real in my everyday, it really struck me to say, Rudo, you've got to make this a reality. God has to be your source, because there's no amount of thinking or cracking that, you know, can make you come out of some of the bigger things that you need done besides just leaning and saying, you know what, God, you are my source. And from morning, you know, I was meditating and reading on this scripture. It's from Psalms 28, but verse 7 is the one that has really just been ringing in my head, and I've been, you know, reciting it over and over again. And it says, "The Lord is my strength and my shield. My heart trusted in him and I am helped. The Lord is my strength and my shield. My heart trusted in him and I am saved." And then it starts talking about praise. It starts talking about joy. "Therefore, my heart greatly rejoices, and with my song I will praise him. Therefore, my heart greatly rejoices, and with my song I will praise him." This morning as well, when I woke up, I just decided to deliberately just praise God and just say, "You know what, God, thank you for life. Thank you that we have food on our table. Thank you that we have clothes to wear." You know, just thanking God for the smallest of things that I can think of. Because if we focus on the bigger things that we don't have, the things that we are trying to get done and all that, you know, we'll get ourselves into a place of stress and a place of frustration, which, you know what you cannot change, you cannot change. What you can change is your praise, is your faith and your trust in God. I just want to encourage someone, entrepreneur, you're self-employed, you do your own things, just trust God. Let God be your source. Let God be your source. I know it's not like an overnight thing where you can wake up and you really say, okay, yes, God is my source. But find a scripture. Find a scripture. Like I found this Psalm 28 verse 7, and I've been speaking it, I've been just thinking through over it and just saying, you know what, God, this has to be my reality. Lord, you are my strength, you are my shield, my heart is trusting in you, and I will find my help in you, because you are my source. My salary is not my source, my pockets are not my source, you, God, are my source. So I just want to encourage someone that keep holding on, keep trusting. Keep trusting. God is faithful. Let the word of God begin to dwell richly in you. It means, dwelling richly means you've got to keep speaking it. You've got to keep speaking it until you begin to believe it. Because you cannot let stress be an option. You don't want to come out of this lockdown with so many sicknesses and ailments because of stress, because of worry. But just trust God. Just trust God. He's faithful. Let's walk this journey together. I'm also daily encouraging myself, like David in the Psalms. He encouraged himself in the Lord. So let's encourage ourselves unto the good and positive things. We want to come out stronger. We want to come out better because we only have God. Take care.